Next up, we have Rebecca Tippett, and she sends me a really nice email every day because I'm on her own listserv, and tells me all kinds of fantastic data, information that I actually use a lot. So thank you for what you do and getting information out there.
Thank you. Good evening. And before I go ahead and get started, I want to get a sense of how representative you guys are of the Triangle region as a whole. So show of hands if you were not born in North Carolina. Look around the room. We see this is not a representative sample. About two of every three Triangle area residents were not born in North Carolina. And that's adults. When you consider the child population, it's still the majority, about 55%. And this has been a major change from just 36 years ago in 1980, when more than two of three residents were North Carolina born. And this is not because native-born North Carolinians are fleeing the state just to be replaced by transplants, but it's because North Carolina, fueled by growth of Raleigh and Charlotte metros, has increasingly been pulling individuals in from other states and countries at a rate that it never did before. And migration has been and continues to be the major driver of population change in this area. As of 2015, the three-county Triangle region had 1.5 million residents. And I'm about to show you some, I'll say, lightly manipulated census data that I created just to give you a sense of what you can do to enrich your projects with some of the data that exists free and publicly available out there. If you have ever worked with census data or read about census data, you may have heard the term block group. This is a statistical area. It doesn't cohere to any meaningful municipality necessarily. All that you need to know is that it is the smallest geography at which the Census Bureau publishes detailed population data. And the great thing about populous areas is they have a lot of block groups in them. So we can get really rich and informative insights about what's going on in a place, which we'll turn to now. So between 2000 and 2010, the Triangle region grew by 333,000 individuals. This map highlights where the population growth occurred. Red areas, there aren't many of them, but there are some, are areas of population loss. And you can see that those are mainly distressed tracts in downtown areas. And the blue corresponds to areas that have population growth. The darker the blue, the greater the growth. You can see that that's very concentrated in the suburbs around Raleigh and Wake County, as well as southeastern Durham. But I mentioned that migration has been a major factor and a major force fueling this. So not only has North Carolina and the Triangle region pulled in individuals from across the states and across the nation, we are increasingly an immigrant destination as well. And much like the United States, those immigrant streams are dominated by two global regions, Latin America and Asia. But where those individuals land when they arrive here is very different. So if we look at the Asian population, between 2000 and 2010, that population more than doubled. And although you see some pockets of growth around Chapel Hill and Durham, as well as Wake Forest and Raleigh, really this occurred in two places, Cary and Morrisville. When we look at the Hispanic population, on the other hand, this was, okay, my slides are cut off, it appears. When we look at the Hispanic population, although this was faster and occurred much more dispersed across the region, with few exceptions, where Hispanic population grew and where the Asian population grew were not the same places. And what this means is that your perception of and your experience of diversity in the region will vary significantly based on where you live. So this was not my next slide, so we're just going to wing it. Based on this, also where you live is going to inform what you think about this question. What percentage of area residents do you think were born in another country? Any guesses? 30. 30? Okay, so that's a little high. It's 14%, about 1 in 7, which is more than 3 times the rate that it was in 1990, just 4%. So what do we think top 3 countries of origin?
India.
Okay, so you guys are Cary and Morrisville, I can tell. Actually, it's Mexico. 1 in 4 foreign-born residents in the region was born in Mexico. We've seen a major shift the past few years. You may not know this, but the leading origin of foreign-born individuals is now India, now China. So 14% were born in India, 8% were born in China. And this is just a little taste of some of the information you can get from the census data. I also would encourage you that we have this great, rich microdata that is free, publicly available, and you can not only look at where people are, how they're living, but economic well-being, income and occupation, and really informative stuff to provide context to the open data that you may be pulling into your project. So thank you very much.